that was 10 years ago. If you know, you know. If you know, you know. This thing of ours, oh, this thing of ours. A fraternity of ringing off. I just happen to be alumni. Too legit, they still looking at me with one eye. The company I keep is not corporate enough. Child, you ain't orphan enough. A rapper turn can morph into us, but a turn rapper can morph into Puff. Dance contest for the I predict Al Roker. If you know, you know. I only ever looked up to you all get a bird. This Oprah. Do you walk away? If you know, you know. When we all clicking like Golden State, and you and your team are the motorcade. If you know, you know. Been granting wishes like a genie to bad in two-piece bikinis. I've been hiding where you can see me. The skybox is right next to Riri's. Solely responsible for showing rappers how to stand on the front lines when started throwing bands. Where were you when Big brought the tigers in, cause I was busy earning stripes like a tiger skin. Players in ball shorts, coaching from the side of the ball court. If you know, you know. One stop like a Walmart, we got the for the wrong sport. You know, you know. If you know about the court, though it's supposed to be awkward. If you know, you know. That's the reason we for circle round, fight for the encore. If you know, you know.
All right, Coach, it's the NFL on EA Sports as you take a look there at Lincoln Financial Field in Philadelphia, PA. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Detroit Lions and the Philadelphia Eagles. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Now a play fake here on first down. Looking for Jeffrey, and it's intercepted. Picked off near the 32.
I should have done
it. And he'll return it to the 24-yard line. Well, when you start thinking of guys that are in the mix for Defensive Player of the Year, I think you use him as Exhibit A. Maybe he's not the leading guy right now, but he's at least on the periphery and deserves to be in the discussion.
And because of that, he's looking at a game today where, in order to make that big move and maybe become the guy, he needs multiple takeaways, multiple big plays, things that get our attention and reverberate for weeks to come.
A gain of 3, second down.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, those big defensive linemen will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Now the Notre Dame man, this is Theo Riddick. And he's going to have just a couple here with a marker on the field as well. So this will be accepted as it moves the offense backwards. Carr to throw on second down. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Pressure, and that's certainly going to be a key to this game going forward. And that time, they were able to get in there and influence the throw. And remember, quarterbacks got to get rid of it. They don't have the tougher role that they can fall back on anymore.
And that is incomplete. Before the game, they were running the route tree about as efficiently and effectively as we could have possibly imagined. But sometimes the passes just go awry.
Yeah, let's face it. When you're running the route tree in pregame, defenders breathing down your neck. You don't have defensive backs making plays on the football. Hard to replicate the intensity of the game in pregame.
Wentz and the Eagles now with a first and 10 at their 36-yard line. Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. That ball's caught. Right side. And he's going to be taken down here with a penalty flag on the field. So a decent gain, but all for naught on the penalty.
It's too bad, isn't it? They were feeling pretty good about it. Only people celebrating, the guys who just gave up that play.
Shotgun now for Wentz. He's going to loft one deep left side here. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Jamal Agnew. And they are going to set up shop at the 32-yard line. They told us repeatedly earlier in the week in our meetings, we need some plays from our defense here on the road early. They got one.
And don't think they were above all week long pointing out to their defense that the other defense is rated higher than them. You going to let that happen, guys? Is that how we're going to play? And they responded to the challenge. Well, that was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. On second down, here's Carr. And that's complete to Jesse James. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. The reception good for 7. It's third down. Not a big window to throw. Coverage wasn't too bad there.
Yeah, they had him under wraps pretty well, but somehow able to muscle his way open and catch the ball.
He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Malcolm Jenkins. And his crew will take over at their own 45-yard line. That pick, his 9th on the season.
Remember when we were kids and you were playing Little League Baseball? And they penciled you in the 9 spot in the order. That wasn't so good, was it?
Were you in the 9 hole?
Or you played the 9 position, right field. That wasn't so great.
That wasn't. You're picking dandelions out
exactly.
There.
Exactly. Right?
But the 9 picks,
you want that in a big way. That's a great season.
Heck of a season. So now 2nd and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Working from the gun, Wentz. And the hit jarred it loose. It's incomplete.
Defensively here, you're facing a top 5 team in terms of points scored in the NFL. So when they're that high powered, you've got to find a way to hold them under 20. Because to me, that's the magic number. 20 points scored, you give yourself your best chance to win.
So if they're up around 24, 28, 30, they could be in some trouble.
And I think so, because then you turn it into a shootout, and that means your offense has to keep pace.
Call it a loss of 8 yards on the play. And that's going to bring up a 4th down. They punted 3 times in the loss last week as he sends this one away. This is taken at the 23. And he gets this up just shy of the 30 to the 29 before he's out of bounds. The 4th down run successful. Now they look to pay it off on 1st down. They'll start the drive with a carry by Jones. And he'll slip his way up across the 30 to the 32. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be 2nd down.
I think that's the type of run we'll continue to see throughout this game. The snow coming down, I don't expect a lot of big plays to be broken.
Now Carr throwing on 2nd down. Escaping the pressure right. And they're not able to hook up there. Incomplete.
Well, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, but frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, lived to fight another down, right?
Throwing his Carr on 3rd down. Eagle pressure, too much this time. Down he goes. A few issues here on the offensive line. Apparently, he got sacked 5 times last week. They got to him here in the first quarter.
And I would think that running the ball would be paramount here because it's a different team they're facing, but they watch the film as well. So they'll take many of those same principles and try and apply them in this game to see if they fixed what was wrong with them in the last game.
The Boise State alum, Jay Ajayi. And he'll get this only up to about the 3-yard line. Give him three on first down. It'll set up a second and seven. This is Ajayi. So he got three at one tackle, but couldn't do a whole lot else. It'll be a gain of five, but still about 3 yards shy of the first down marker, and now it's third down. To the 14. It'll go as a gain of six that time, and it moves the chains as well. If you start assessing what went wrong last week, Charles, and their loss had nothing to do with the ground game. They ran it well.
And you also have to say to yourself as a team, don't go away from what worked. That's not the reason the game was lost. Running the football over time, when you do it consistently, usually translates into wins.
And they're hoping to do it consistently here. Wentz now on first down. The connection here with Nelson Aguilar. And they'll bring him down here up at about the 22-yard line. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. Facing a second and two after that last catch. Good for 8 yards. They'll run it now out of the gun. And down he'll go at the 25. Give him 3 yards and a fresh set of downs.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
They go play action here on first down. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. Give him a couple on the catch. It's second and eight.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride, and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Forced out to his left. All in all, no gain on the play, and it'll bring up third.
And while he did a good job of sliding around in the pocket, there was nowhere to go with the football, so he had to take off and try and run. He just got back to the line of scrimmage, no gain.
Now Wentz on third down. A reception made by Alshon Jeffery. And he gets this one just shy of the 40. They'll mark him down at the 39. Now first catch for Jeffery. Good enough for a first down. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Wentz now on first down. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes.
This offensive line has struggled. In fact, when we sat down with the coach, he said it's been in tatters lately. They allowed 6 sacks in their last game. Just gave up another one right there.
In tatters, so it sounds a little bit like this right now.
Exactly. It's like that paper being ripped. And right now, they've got to find a way to get it back together.
Oh, wow. Fucking garbage.
They went backwards 7 yards, setting up a tough third down. Back live with Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gauden. It's the Eagles with the ball here to begin quarter number two. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after first and second down went backwards. It's third and very long. They'll run it now out of the gun. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. They'll get 6 there on the run, but it brings up 4th down.
And there's a run to be happy with. Good, solid yardage. You'll take that any time you hand the ball to a back.
He steps into this one, and this is a rocket.
Come on, go.
And this will hit just beyond the goal line as it's into the end zone for a touchback. So the Lions offense ready to go back out onto the field. And on the last go-around, they really couldn't get anything going.
They had to punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. Hey, Looking to throw on second down. Carr, he sets to fire deep. Oh, he almost had it.
Boy, if he would have caught
that. One interception, just missing his second there.
The name of the game is always on defense. Put pressure on the quarterback, and that's exactly what they've done today. It looks like they've got him a little bit rattled. That would have been the second interception in the first half.
On third and long, it's Carr. And he's going to be taken down, sacked back at the two. Derek Barnett in there to drop him for his fifth sack of the year. Here's Marquette King now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. They knew they were going to have great field position, went all out, got a little too aggressive.
And you have to understand your angles. They're cut down. When they're that backed up, you've got to be careful going after them.
So a big break. The roughing the kicker called on fourth down leads to first and 10. The give is to Jones. And he'll take this up only to about his 18-yard line. And credit the tackle to Derek Barnett.
Well, we saw him there trying to get it to the outside, trying to get to the perimeter, but not a whole lot of room there. But there's got to be one positive to that. If you keep moving laterally, creases tend to develop as the game moves on, and they can run it back inside later.
Limited running room as he'll get about 3 to the 21.
Some of these play calls, I think they're a little conservative. Well, you know me, because it's easy to sit up in this booth, right, and make all the calls and think I'm going to be correct. I would like to see them.
And he's going to lose a yard or two. Taken down behind the line. Derek Barnett in there to drop him for his fifth sack of the year. His first punt, 45 yards. This looks good as well. Taken at about the 36. A 41-yard punt, 9 on the return. And the Eagles will have it, taking over first and 10. Wentz and the Eagles now with a first and 10 at the 45. On play action, Wentz eluding the pressure right.
The line getting folded, bro.
Options,
fucking
he just
folded, man.
Now that'll
can't
bring
get no
up
fucking
second
time
down.
In the pocket.
What's the old adage? Be quick, but don't hurry. Well, that went right out the window there. He was hurried, harassed. That ball had to be gotten rid of. Otherwise, he was going to get sacked.
Wentz will try again on second down.
Bro, this is not real, bro. My O-line cannot be this bad. Yeah, I'm running the ball the rest of the game, bro. I'm running power. Yeah, he just fucking dogged my D-line.
And there have been two ways of getting ready for this. Some have said, don't worry about the weather. Just practice in your normal conditions and handle it on game day. And others have said, find some weather, find some conditions somewhere, and try and get ready. What do you think?
Well, whatever the preparation there, the snow causing the fumble. And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on it at second down. Earlier in the quarter when the defense was keying on the run, you said offensively they need to open things up, take some shots downfield. Didn't work there, but they did.
Yeah, I'm not going to change my tune now. I still think it's the right play because when you take those shots downfield, you open the eyes of the defense to what you could do to them, and that may open some things up for you offensively.
Just a couple there on the second down run. Now they're staring at a 3rd and 8 situation. Working from the gun, it's Carr. Throwing deep for Galladay. Oh, it's a touchdown if he holds on. Instead, it's 4th down. Seems like this defense, especially the secondary, has really been contesting about every throw in this first half.
Remind me of a good half-court defensive basketball team. Every time a pass is thrown, they're right there and gets the good defensive position, able to affect the play.
So 2 missed field goals for him now, and that's helped keep them with a big 0 on the scoreboard.
Well, it's not the only reason they have a 0. The offense has been bogged down a few times now, but it's certainly not helping the cause any at all.
They'll start out on the ground with a J. He'll get about 3 as he's brought down right around the 42.
One thing to keep in mind, partner, especially in the second half, when you've got a running back of this size, of these dimensions, I can just tell you, attrition does set in for a defense because you're excited about hitting him in the first half. Maybe not so much in the second half, and some of these shorter gains turn into bigger runs later.
Play action. Now Wentz. And that'll be incomplete. Alshon Jeffrey, the intended receiver. And it'll bring up third down. Defensively, Charles, they continue to really limit this offense as far as yardage goes.
Yeah, you're exactly right. They've been assignment sound, staying in their lanes, keeping proper leverage, and communicating well, too.
From the gun on third down, Wentz. And Jeffrey's got it. And he's able to get this one down to the 40-yard line.
Thank you, Costin, for throwing the ball high.
18 yards there and a first down. He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a first down.
Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it second and a foot or so. Here's Ajayi, and he'll go down at the 28. 2 yards on the pickup there, but it's enough to give him a new set of downs.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield, because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are, stay with who you know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
He's able to get six, a nice pickup down to the 21. 2 minutes remain in a scoreless first half. We'll come back to Philadelphia after this. Now it's Ajayi. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. 8 yards on the pickup there, and it moves the sticks.
Yeah, once more, strong running, excellent blocking at the point of attack. They've got a nice little drive brewing right here.
They run with Ajayi. A nice display of powerful running, but it takes him only to the 7. He's dropped there. And now the Lions going to stop us momentarily as they call a timeout, as they'll talk things over prior to this upcoming second down play. And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And they'll get him down here at about the 5-yard line. The Lions now going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important third down. Now a toss play. It's Ajayi. And he's in. Touchdown, Eagles. Jay Ajayi with touchdown number 12 on the year. And the Eagles are able to cash it in for 6. And he's able to put it through. Elliott now to kick this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one, as it's through the end zone for a touchback. The Lions offense, they get ready to head back onto the field. And last time out, another missed field goal, so maybe their confidence wavering a little bit right now in the kicking game.
And I'm with you on that. I think at this stage, they'd love to not run him back out there in a tough situation. But let's face it,
he's got a man complete. And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. And that one results in 35 yards. Carr now on first down. A dump underneath to Jones. And he's going to get this inside the 30. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks.
So many times you hear today's NFL described as a space game. Get your best players into space with the football in their hands. That's why sometimes you swing it out to your runner, get him out in the flat, and let him have a chance to make people miss an open field.
And it's incomplete.
This defense has been very disruptive early on as they force another one to go awry.
Seems to be the front and the back in pass rush. They've been able to get home, and they're taking the ball away in coverage as well.
I love how you put it together. The front and back working in sync. Only way to play good defense.
Carr again here on 2nd and 10. It's incomplete. Took a
picks,
shot, couldn't connect.
Passes.
Well, one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown them a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after them. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. This offense was on the move. Now two straight incompletions have them looking at 3rd and 10. To throw his car. He's going to go on top for the end zone. And incomplete. He can't hang on. Would have been a nice catch. Instead, it brings up a 4th down.
This team is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. He came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
So that now 3 misses here in this first half.
And the important thing is you just can't get discouraged. You may still have some chances to make amends in the second half, so you've got to get yourself in the right frame of mind to get the job done.
On 1st down, Wentz. Big loss here as he's taken down. Von Miller in there to get him. And that is sack number 15 for him on the year. Sacks a growing theme in this first half. This is 2nd and long. And they'll go on the ground. And he goes nowhere. He'll lose yardage back at the 17. And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense. As he'll stop it with 13 seconds to play in half number one. Need something from deep in the bag of tricks here after 1st and 2nd down went backwards. It's 3rd and very long. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. They get 13, but it's not nearly enough. And it'll be 4th down. So we've reached halftime with just the lone. There you have it. Halftime quickly over. 3rd quarter, here we go. Okay, Coach, appreciate it. A 1-touchdown game here as we get set to resume play in the second half. This will be fielded at the 8. And a nice return sets him up pretty good here at the 30-yard line. The Lions offense now with a football first cool here to begin quarter number 3. They're down here, but
we'll get from under the fucking covers.
Game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. Ball on the 30 as they come up 2nd and 10. Carl try it again on 2nd down. And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete.
We've seen these defenses make enough opportunistic plays to keep this one low scoring. Flying around, making plays on the ball. And we see yet another errant throw as a result.
Big play coming up. Here's 3rd and 10.
I would expect to see some pressure here.
And the blitz does come. Drops it to Jones in the flat.
I didn't even have enough time to run there, bro.
It earns him a fresh shot of downs.
Madden, I see what type of
and this is why trying to cover the angle route is so difficult. Anyone playing the linebacker position, when they see a running back out of the backfield widen because he heads towards the flat first, oftentimes you widen too much and overcommit. He cuts up inside, and that's what we saw there. A nice pickup.
Why is my what is my pass rush doing? Are they just watching this nigga sit there and throw the ball? What are y'all doing?
A really good pickup of 28 yards. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. 1st and 10. On 1st down, Carr throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. Call it a 3-yard gain, and it'll bring up a 2nd down. 6:37. Again, they'll throw with Carr. Throwing the outlet.
Stop going for the pit, nigga.
It's James. And he's able to get it to the edge of the red zone at the 20-yard line. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a 3rd down. The Lions on 3rd down. Just 1 conversion in 8 tries. Not good. They need just 1 yard here. It's 3rd and 1. Now whistles and a flag down. Looked like one of the Lions linemen might have moved. Well, that's a tough, costly penalty because now it makes it 3rd and 6 after the false start.
7:34. Now, ready?
Again, it's Carr.
There's no way you need to let him make that catch.
And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. First time they've looked his way in this game. He comes through picking up the first. Carr now perfect since the second half started. 7 of 7. It's first and 10. They'll pitch it out to Jones. And he's able to find some room as they get him down after a good run. 9 yards is the pickup there, and they'll have a second and one.
This is why I pay
some good strong running right there, some power and some explosiveness just about got him into the end zone.
They'll go again to Jones, and that one blown up quickly, as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. That'll be a loss of a yard, and it leads to a third down. The Lions on third down, not so hot, 2 for 9 to this point. They're up against a 3rd-and-1 situation. They'll try and run for it with Jones. And they got 3 yards, that's enough. A conversion, and now it's 1st-and-goal. Now, they struggled to get him rolling on the ground in the first half, and that's sort of continuing here in the third quarter.
Yeah, but I don't think it's time to abandon the running game. I would say keep feeding the horse, and I believe he'll eventually reward them, especially as we get deeper in the game.
And they'll turn to a power game to try to get in. Power on power, but he's not going to get in. No gain on the play, and it's going to be 2nd-and-goal. He'll get it up the middle.
I think I'm running the same play, bro. This big goofy ass.
Nick Bonham, his first touchdown on the year. And the Lions are an extra point away from tying this thing up. You always worry about the plant foot in the snow, but no problems there. And we are tied at 7. Nothing separating these two teams on the scoreboard as the kick's away here. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. So here are the Eagles now as they get set for their first possession of the second half. Wentz and the Eagles now with a 1st and 10 at their own 25-yard line. On play action, it's Wentz. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And pops.
Who is that, Mac Hollins?
There, jarred the ball loose and brings up second down.
She probably won't be in the game.
We've seen good cover skills on display throughout this game, really from both teams. And there's another nice example there of them making it difficult to complete a pass.
Back to the air on 2nd down. Wentz. Jeffrey with a catch left side.
God damn, I was trying
to get to the 29-yard line brought down there. 4 yards on the completion, and it sets up a 3rd down.
I always laugh when people say, what's the toughest route to defend? And I'm like, any of them, especially if it's a good receiver, that makes things very difficult. But when you're running a drag route, something
short, my fucking God.
Defenders, using guys almost as screens in order to get open, that makes things tougher, guys trying to get to the football.
Now throwing on 3rd down there, but he cannot connect. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. So that one will be accepted. So the special teams penalty cost some yardage there as they come out on 1st and 10. Throwing on 1st down is Carr. Got his man complete over the middle. That's James. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. A gain of 6 there on 1st.
Now that's staying ahead of the chains. Really good pickup on 1st down, hitting the tight end there. Now brings up a 2nd and manageable.
Just found a hole in that zone. On 2nd down, it's Jones. And the hole closes quickly. He gets it across the 35 to the 36-yard line. 2 yards on the carry there, and it's going to lead him to 3rd down. Again, it's Jones. And he's got the 1st before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. Only 3 there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. Carr now on 1st down. Flush to his right.
We can't catch Derek Carr, y'all, for real.
Take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. The escapability in evidence there is that one good for 15 and a first. So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 46. And he's going to be met at about the 43. A gain of 3, second down.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays.
Rodney McLeod.
The overall essence of the running game.
18 yards the gain for number 18.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it because you're running away from people on it.
Now a first down carry by Jones. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of 2 there, bringing up second down.
I'm getting the sense that Fletcher Cox is making offensive linemen want to take the week off when they have to play against him.
It's a regular routine for him, isn't it?
It really is. That play there, that's him all day long. Good luck trying to block him and keep him from disrupting your offense.
Nigel Bradham brings him down.
On a second and long, it's really nice to see an offense that has enough confidence to run the football in that situation. I think that goes back to their practice and game planning. They've seen things that they've seen on tape and in previous games that led them to believe that even in a long-distance situation, they can still run the football and gain enough yardage to put themselves in a good spot on third down.
Keeps it on the sneak, and he'll get him a bit closer as he's down to the 2-yard line. Only a yard on the keeper, and it'll be second down.
Okay, got him halfway there. You don't see the sneak all that often from the 2-yard line because you definitely don't want to see your quarterback get clobbered. But you wonder if we might see the same play again.
Now whistles and a flag down. Looked like one of the Lions linemen might have moved. Things made a little more difficult after the false start as they try again on second and goal. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he gets it a little bit closer. He takes it from the 6 inside the 5 to the 4.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, third and goal. Shotgun now for Carr. He lost a big chunk, 6 yards there, and it leads to fourth down. So the field goal unit is on the field, as this is a big spot right here. And he missed it. It's no good, and a costly one there as this game remains tied here in the fourth. And that one, my goodness, that was almost too easy.
Yeah, you not got too many attempts shorter than that one, and I don't think this was blocked. That's about as bad a miss as you can have.
Some good games going on in the early window. This might be the best of the bunch. Now a play fake here on first down. He'll buy some time right. Wide open receiver complete. And they'll get it all the way up about 5 yards shy of midfield. A really nice gain of 25 yards. The big play to start him out. Has him at the 45 already. Now a play fake. Wentz. Gonna look deep for Jeffrey. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
There's definitely contact there, but it's the fourth quarter of a kind of tight game, and sometimes the officials just say, let them play. Kind of like your mom used to, you and your brothers, just take the broom to you and send you out to the backyard and tell you to settle it yourselves.
I like that. Yeah, there was contact. I don't know, like you said, enough to warrant the flag. It was close, though.
It's complete. Left side, Aguilar. And he's going to get this down to the 35-yard line. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
And in this weather, I know you weren't a quarterback. You were on the defensive side of things. But how hard is it to throw that football?
It can't be easy because you never know how the moisture is going to affect things. And each quarterback handles it differently. Some of them are a little bit better than others. Depends whether they wear a glove, not wear a glove. How cold is it? You know, all those things go into it. But it goes to everything else. Keeping your footing when you're running routes. Supposedly, you have the advantage as a receiver because you know where you're going. But that's not easy as well. Finally, just locating the ball when it finally comes through the snow. Kids love it. Kids love snow. Players, not so much at times.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete. They'll go again here from the 10-yard line on second and goal. They'll give it to him up the middle. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. A nice run there as he picks up six. It's going to be third and goal now. Two straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists, and if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that second down is the time you go play action and throw the ball. I say commit to the run and think about it being four down territory.
No gain on the play that time, so a big stop, and it's going to leave them with a fourth and goal. And Elliott puts this one through. And they take the lead here now at 10-7. So the drive here ends with a field goal. It does give them the lead, but this one's still certainly a long ways from over.
It definitely puts a lot of pressure on your defense to hold the lead, right? They're happy to have it and happy to be out there trying to do so. But I know as a former player, in the back of their mind, they're thinking, why don't you score the touchdown and seal this thing?
And Detroit getting set to go now. And they had compiled a pretty long drive last time. Unfortunately, though, it ended with no points after the missed field goal.
And that can hurt the psyche of a team because as they drove downfield, you know you're never supposed to count points in your mind until they go up on the board. But let's face it, we've been there. We've seen teams before. They were counting on those points. They didn't get them. Can they come back now, start over again, and grind it out?
Now Carr throwing on second down. Over the middle complete.
Bruh,
that's
just nigga.
And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A really good pickup of 28 yards. So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 46. From the gun, it's Carr. Fighting his safety valve here. That's complete.
That nigga, bro.
He is out of
every
bounds
time,
inside the
bro,
35.
Every time.
12
every
more
time.
Yards
flat,
there
flat,
and another
flat,
first
flat,
down.
Flat.
Everyone's got to be able to catch the football. Doesn't matter what position you play, but if you're on offense,
yeah,
be aware
flat.
A ball may come your way.
On first and 10, here's Carr. Spins by. He couldn't quite
Dude.
Hold it. Got hit.
Ball
pops out. Incomplete. We have not seen a whole lot of wide-open receivers. Everything seemingly has been contested.
And that's another nice job there to force an incompletion. They've been very cohesive, knowing each other's moves all game long, and they've been on the spot just about every time.
Yeah. Yeah. Held them in check on the scoreboard. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown. And that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. Now Jones. And he'll go backwards, losing yardage to the five. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down.
Oh, partner, that play brought back memories. Watching them string it out, letting the runner get all the way to the sideline area, but not letting him get out of bounds. They formed that picket fence and didn't allow him through.
Not only that, got him for a loss as well here. And one of the reasons they lead in the fourth quarter, plays like that.
Yeah, took a little more.
And that is good. Touchdown, Detroit. Jesse James, his third touchdown now on the year. And the Lions have taken the lead here in the fourth quarter. And it's no good. Well, that could be a critical miss here in a one-score game in the fourth. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. This one taken from the seven. And an alley to run. He's at the 50. So that will push him back.
And now we know why I had a little extra space to run, don't we? An illegal block in the back. That penalty removed them back.
So the special teams penalty cost some yardage there as they come out on first and 10. They go play action here on first down. And some room to run now. Defensively, you said coming in earlier in the broadcast, the magic number was 20 points for you. That's what you thought they would have to hold this offense to, or less than that. And, wow, they've done that in a big way, haven't they?
Not only have they done it, they put themselves in a great position to win this one because holding them down was paramount. If they could get it done, and guess what? We see the end result. Right now, they have their eye on victory.
And leading here in the fourth. Catch number 44 of on the year. It's a first down.
Looked like the defense put pretty good pressure on him, but he's able to flush out to his right to try and evade people. On the run, had to get on his horse. Still accurately throws a nice pass for a first down.
Now Wentz.
That's a max protection.
There. That's really gonna set
I just went
for
max protection, and this nigga is still dog.
And this will probably be the final play before
this
the
shit's
two-minute
crazy,
warning.
Bro. Somebody go get that nigga, bro.
On second down, here's Wentz. He's got Dallas Goedert, his tight end, over the middle. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. Time for a break. We'll come back for the electrifying conclusion after this. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll take this one up close to about the 45. Give him a couple on the run as it brings up the fourth down. This late in the game, Charles, I think you maybe seriously have to think about going for it.
Especially where they are in terms of field position, because this is almost like no man's land. Might hurt your punter because there might not be enough space, maybe too far for your field goal kicker. I'm like the old rule. Possession is 9/10 of the law. Possession is 9/10 of winning the game. Go for it. Get the first down. Close it out.
It's a sneak. It's Wentz. And he will push forward and pick up the first down. They keep the game alive, at least for the moment, as it's a first down.
They had to convert there on fourth down, and they ran the football. Major surprise, but they pick it up. Now they've got to really hurry.
Two first downs have them up near midfield now on first and 10. He's back to throw.
Where's my protection?
So a loss of five, and it'll be second down.
Oh,
and we've reached
God.
The 1 minute mark in this game.
I get some protection? Please.
He'll look to throw.
Fuck. Bruh. Oh my god, bruh. This nigga Carson Wentz is hilariously bad, bro.
For the big one there on second down. Now they're likely down to their final two plays.
And you know they've got to keep going for the big shot, right? So defensively, you play what they call top down. Nothing behind you. Make everything get completed in front.
They'll look to throw. Drops it off to Ajayi. Give him three on the play. And that'll bring up fourth down.
Well, that's certainly playing down and distance very well by the defense, isn't it? Take whatever you want underneath, by all means.
One score down. Here we go. They're going to go for it here on fourth down. Back to throw. Looking for his tight end on the corner. It's complete. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here.
I thought
as the clock will stop with just under 30 seconds left to go.
Hang in there now.
From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Back to throw. Rifles one incomplete. He was trying to get it to Jay Ajayi there out of the backfield. And that'll bring up second down. So he's unable to complete it there, and just not the game that you would expect from him. He's been off the mark really start to finish.
Yeah, it makes you wonder what exactly is going on. Is he a little bit dinged up here? Or is it just off just by a bit? Maybe he can get it back in this situation. He'll need to.
His throw caught right around the six. And finally, down he goes as they work it inside the 10 to the 7. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead, as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the ballgame. Only way to get the lead here, of course, with a touchdown. And that's what they're gunning for on first and goal. Oh, how about this on first and goal? And he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the 7. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
I like the idea to mix it up from time to time because, let's face it, you can't be predictable. But the execution was a little lacking on this one, right? They might want to go back to the drawing board with that call.
And a timeout comes in. The whistles blow with 3 seconds remaining. And his kick is indeed good. It's a little teaching moment here. Overtime rules. Remind us how this goes, partner.
Okay, so in the past, we had sudden death. First team to score wins, but no longer. Now, if the team receives the ball, scores a touchdown, they win the game.
So a tie ball game here as the kick's away. And this will be a touchback as that sails over the end line. And out now come the Eagles. They control their own destiny here. They have the football in overtime. Obviously, a touchdown would win it.
And I think teams around the league are still adjusting to the idea of going downfield, scoring a touchdown wins the game, because they were used to just going downfield and trying to get in field goal range to win a game. Still having to make that transition. Let's face it now, the ones who are doing it best know they need to go down, attack, put the ball in the end zone, and not leave it up to a field goal and give the other team a chance.
Yeah, as we said, they control their own destiny now. So one play, and they're already just shy of midfield. On play action, Wentz. He's going to let this go deep. Back up. It's caught inside the 25. A gain of 32 that time.
Not only have they completed a couple on this drive, but they peeled off some pretty good chunks of yardage, too.
Absolutely. Great start. Two nice plays in the pass game. Now can they continue to feed off that? They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. 5 yards on the carry. Good pickup on first down.
And I know what does that have to do with me being
cold? In overtime, you're just saying, if you're that ball carrier, hold on to the football.
Hold on to it, protect it, but not necessarily settle it, because you're trying to get to the end zone. You're trying to end the game right here.
Oh, time out. It's cold in here, right?
Poking, clawing, raking, trying to knock the ball free and protect their end zone.
Yeah, like you alluded to, especially this part of the field.
Always wanting to get dirty. To dirty ass.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And they'll get him down here about the 5-yard line. Only a yard that time, second and goal.
I didn't quite get you.
And the last carry puts him right at 100 yards for the game. So
I'm sorry,
because he's been patient, followed his blocks, let everything develop, and then burst through for big gains.
You want your ass whooped, don't you?
He'll get it up the middle. And that'll get him halfway there as he takes it from the 6 to the 3-yard line. This is kind of one of those in-between plays here, Charles, on third and goal from the 2 or the 3 in that area. What do you dial up?
Something quick hitting. You don't have the time for something that develops slowly. It's got to be right at them if you're going to run the football. If you're going to throw it, something quick, get it out of your hand.
And he's in the end zone for the touchdown and the game winner in OT.
I'm feeling like a boss right now. I'm gonna Thank you.
think